Yo, what's up guys, it's your boy XpeK. So for today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I'm personally ranking up inside Rise of Iron. I've seen a lot of videos in my subbox recently of how they're personally ranking up for Rise of Iron. I noticed a lot of people are doing the Omnigol farm, which does work, but my group was having a little trouble killing her every time. And when you farm Omnigol, you do get good gear consistently, but you're missing out on Vanguard rep, you're missing out on exotic engram drops. I personally think it's just much better to run the strikes instead of just farming Omnigol over and over. I've also noticed that some people are like opening their exotic engrams after they beat the campaign, and I'm like, no, don't do that, you're supposed to wait till later. So I'm going to try my best to explain why you want to save certain things and open certain things right away. So the first step I would suggest for you guys is to save up your exotic engrams for as long as possible. Exotic engrams can decrypt past 365, and you'll see why in just a second. With Rise of Iron, Bungie let us do hoarding techniques, which I was actually really surprised. I don't think there's ever been. This is the first expansion where, actually, this may be the first, I'm not too sure. This may be the first expansion where if you hoarded engrams and other materials, they actually benefited you. So in my vault, I had a bunch of legendary engrams saved up thinking I could use them for legendary marks, but actually I can use them for infusion fuel. Now if you guys didn't do any hoarding techniques, it's not a big deal, it's not the end of the world, you can still hit 365 relatively quick. So what I recommend you do is every time you get a blue or a purple or a legendary that is higher light than your current gear, just equip it. Some people may say I'm doing it wrong, but I had so many legendary marks, anything I would get that was above, I would just infuse it right away because I had so much materials. I had a bunch of bounties saved up that give me legendary marks. I was just infusing everything into my legendary set that I currently had. So if you're trying the power level relatively quickly, just equip everything that's higher light, and once you get to the 362, 363, 364 mark, that's when you could probably start infusing into your legendary set that you want to keep. So your character will look pretty goofy with blues and like unleveled purples on, but up until the 365 light mark, it doesn't really matter if your gear is rare or legendary. Now when it comes to engrams, guys, I want you to understand like the tiers of engrams. So blue engrams can only decrypt up to 340. Now if a blue engram decides to turn legendary, it'll actually be light level appropriate up until the 365 light margin. And finally, exotic engrams. Now exotic engrams, I would highly recommend you save them up until you hit 365 light, and even a little bit beyond that, I would say like 367, 368, because once you hit 365 light, you're going to plateau. And once you hit 365 light, the only way to rank up is through faction packages, Vanguard, Crucible, just packages as general is just your best surefire way to rank up once you hit 365 light. So in my opinion, the best way to get engrams, the faction rep, the Vanguard rep, basically what you want to live in is the Siva Crisis Heroic Strikes. Yesterday, I think for about 8 hours, I was doing strikes, and I managed to go from like 351 light to around 365 light before I went to bed. So if you grind these strikes long enough, you will definitely see the increase to your light, and you will start to see what I call the snowball effect. Basically, once you get your light really high, when you switch characters and move your weapons around, your ghosts and your artifact, you will see the snowball effect of your characters building up light very quickly. And also, once you get your light level up, it makes the strikes so much more easier, and you know, you'll go from doing 20 to 30 minutes on a strike to 15 minutes tops on a strike. Now the strikes do have arc burn. I recommend you have the Zalo Supercell or a arc sniper. Definitely use the arc subclass. That way you could just shred through everything with arc burn. And I will say some of the strikes are a little tough. So yes, do this with some of your friends. That way you don't get stuck with randoms that are like AFK or anything like that. So like I said earlier, you don't have to do this like me where I'm infusing everything. You can equip the blues and legendaries up until you plateau around 365 light, and then you can infuse that gear into a legendary set or exotic set that you want to keep forever or take it to the raid this Friday. So that is going to be it for today, guys. Right now is a look at my current character. I'm currently at 365 light. I'm working my way up to 366. Today I'm going to do a whole nother day of grinding strikes and maybe Archon's Forge, see if I can hit 370 light. And tomorrow on Friday, on raid day, I'm probably going to open up my exotic engrams and see if I can jump up to 380 possibly. So I hope I helped you guys. Please share this video with your friends. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you very so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.